हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो यू हैव सीन हाउ वी स्ट्रक्चर्ड आर फॉर्म यूजिंग HTML5। ओके, एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई गोना शो यू हाउ टू इंक्लूड फॉन्ट ऑसम लाइब्रेरी इनटू योर डॉक्यूमेंट। ओके, एंड देन आई विल शो यू हाउ टू इनकॉर्पोरेट दोज फॉन्ट ऑसम आइकन्स इनटू योर बटन्स। ओके, एंड देन विल यूज CSS टू स्टाइल दिस फॉर्म। ओके, so let's get started. First of all, I'm going to navigate to Font Awesome website. Here's I'm on Font Awesome website, which is fontawesome.io/get-started. okay, and here you can see that we have a link here. We're gonna grab this link from here. Okay, simply by just copying it, and let's go ahead and paste it inside your head section direct below the meta element. Okay, so I'm gonna paste it here. Now I'm gonna show you how you can include icons into your buttons or anchor elements. Here you can see, here is our first anchor element, and second I'm gonna include Facebook icon here. Okay, and Google icon here. So what will do to include those icons? Well, I'm gonna go ahead to Font Awesome website, and here in icon section just click on all icons and scroll down. Now you will see that here's our Facebook icon. To include this icon, we can go to our text editor and we can simply here create an I element and then give it a class of FA Facebook. FA stands for Font Awesome here. Okay, this is Font Awesome hyphen Facebook icon. So let me show you in browser. Here you can see that we have a F icon displayed here. Okay, now let's go ahead and add Google plus icon. Okay, to do that we can find our Google plus icon here. Okay, so let me show you how do I know that what class do I have to include this icon into our links. So let me click here and switch to this tab. You can see that there is a code here which is I element, and two classes are applied to it. First one is FA, then FA hyphen Google hyphen plus. So we can simply grab this code by copying it, and let's go ahead into our text editor and paste it before our login with Google text here. So this will also include Google plus icon before our login with Google text. Okay, so let's go to our browser and see what it looks like. Here you can see that we have Google plus icon here. Okay, let's jump into our text editor and start styling this form. Okay, so let's switch to main.css file. Here first of all I'm gonna target our main wrapper element, which was this element here, main. So I'll write main, and let's center this wrapper element and give it some width. So I'm gonna apply a width of 35%, mean width of 480 pixels. Okay, and let's apply some margin to it. We're gonna apply 1 rem margin from top and bottom, and auto from left and right. Okay, now I wanna mention one thing. You can see that there is some basic margin and margin and padding styles are applied to common elements here, and you can also see that we have footer and header styles, and here we are applying text decoration none for all of our anchor elements, so that this will remove underline from all our anchor text. Okay, and or links, and you can see that there is a base font size of 15 pixels. So this 15 pixel is equal to 1 RAM for this document. Okay, so when I specify 1 RAM, it means it is equivalent to this 15 pixels. Okay, now guys, I'm gonna apply some basic styles to our form container element. So I'm gonna paste some code here. So you can see that there's a form container ID that we have assigned in our HTML document here. You can see that to our article element, and this will select this article element, and we are applying some box shadow. You can see that there is a horizontal offset, this is vertical offset, and this is blur value, and this is spread value of color 999, and we have also applied some border radius to it and some padding from top and bottom and zero from left and right. So now let's see its preview in our browser. Now our form has some box shadow is applied to it, and also some border radius is applied to it. Okay, now we're gonna style this element here. So I'm gonna go ahead to my text editor, and just here I'm gonna write form container and select that h1 element, and let's apply some basic styles to it, such as center this text and font size and color, etc. So I'm again going to paste some code here so that we can save little bit of time. Okay, you can see that now I have applied some basic text align center, font size of 1.5 RAM, and some color to it, which is this light orange, and padding of 0.8 RAM from top and bottom and zero from left and right. Okay, so now let's see its preview in our browser. Okay, now you can see that some margin, some padding and margins are applied to it, and text align center is applied to it. Now what I wanna do, I wanna close this tab over here and shift this window to the right. Okay, by doing this we can see both our text editor and browser at the same time, and so that we will be able to see preview instantly. Okay, alright friends, now let's go ahead and select this form element which contains all our links and input elements. Okay, and we're gonna apply it some width and make it to the center of its parent element, which is this form container element. Okay, and we'll also apply some margin. So I'm gonna write form container, then I'll write form, inside this form, inside this curly braces, we're gonna write width of 85%. Let's apply a margin of 1 RAM from top and bottom and auto from left and right, so that it will center this form element. Now we are going to style this or separator here, means we want to separate these social media login buttons and these input fields. So we're gonna style this or element, and we want to its both side there will be a parallel lines, horizontal parallel lines. So let's go ahead and target that or text by writing dot or divider, which is the class that we have applied to this or text, and it is a div element. So we're gonna set it position to relative. Okay, and let's set its text align property to center. Okay, and now let's apply some margin to this. So I'll write margin from top and bottom, we're gonna apply it a margin of 2.5 RAM. Okay, and let's apply it margin from left and right. Yep. Now also we are going to apply a color of found DCC1C1. Okay, so now it's turn to create parallel lines to its both side. So I'm gonna write OR divider, and we're gonna utilize after and before pseudo selector to create the line effect. So we're gonna write after, okay, and then we again create OR divider, okay, and then before pseudo selector, and let's set it content property to empty content, and let's display this content as a block so that we can apply some height and borders, etc. So I'm gonna apply height of 0.5 rem and also width of 44%, and why 44%? Because I want 44% of line here to here and 44% line from this side, okay, right hand side, and 44% of line width of this left side, okay. It is going to be clear soon, so wait. And so just copy the code that I'm writing here and you'll soon get to know what I'm talking about. Okay, let me apply a border property, which is border top of 1 pixel solid found FFD0D0. Okay, see that a parallel line is applied to its left hand side. Let's give it a float property of left, and let's also apply a margin top of 5 pixels and text align of center, so that will center it. Okay, and now we're gonna be floating our before element to the right. So I'm gonna write float right, so you can see that we have created our lines to both sides of this element. Okay, now you can see that we are getting a single line on both side of this OR text, that is on the top, because we have only applied border top property to this our after and before pseudo selector of this divider class. So let's apply a border bottom to this class here. So we're gonna write border, so we're gonna write border bottom and give it a border of 1 pixel solid pound FFD0D0. Okay, so this will apply the border bottom to this OR text. So now you can see that we have created our separator between our links, which is social media buttons, and the other thing is our input elements. So now we are going to style our social media login buttons. Okay, so let's go ahead and select our media icons, media buttons, by simply writing their class names. So if you have remembered, we have applied a class called social btn to these two buttons or links, and we are also going to select our input elements, which are email, password and sign in. So we're gonna write input type email. This will select our email field, and I also gonna target our password field. So I'm gonna write type password. Okay, and let's select our submit button, which is sign in button. So let's select our sign in button by writing input type equal to submit. So here we are using
attribute selectors to target these elements at once. So we are going to write some styles here. In fact, I'm gonna paste some code here to save a little bit of time. So give me a second. Here you go. Now you can see that we have displayed all of our links to block, and I have applied this outline none property to get rid of the outlines that is shown when you focus to these input elements. Okay, so let me show you what I'm talking about. So inside this email field, I'm gonna click. Now you cannot see outline because I have already removed that outline by setting its property to outline none. And if I remove this property from here, you can see its effect. Let me again target this. Now you can see that a blue outline is shown. So to remove these outlines, I have put here set a property outline none. And now I have also resetted this box shadow property, and we have applied some margin button proper to all of these elements. So you can see that here. Okay. Now you can see that it has a width of 100% is applied, and we have also set its color to white and line height of 3.5 mm. And basically we are using this 3.5 mm to make this text vertically center. Okay, and we have also applied some border radius and padding right to 1 mm. Let us show you how why this is required. Okay, now it's turn to apply background colors to each of these buttons. Okay, so let's do that. You can see that we have two different classes applied to these elements here, which are buttons, anchor elements. So you can see that this is a social button, which is common to both anchor elements, and here we have FBBTN and GPBTN classes. So we can target these two buttons individually by specifying their classes, unique classes, which are FBBTN and GPBTN. So let's switch into main.css, and here I'm gonna paste some code. Okay, so you can see that, let me resize this for you. You can see that we have applied to FBBTN a background color of this, and also you can see that for Google Plus or Google Plus button GPBTN, we have applied this color here, which is found D34836. Okay, I'll tell you why I applied this transition here. Let me show you. Here we are applying some hover effect to our these two buttons. We are simply changing their background colors, and to make their transition smooth, we are using background transition, which is transition colon 0.1 second background is in out. Okay, and here we are selecting our this Google Plus button and applying another color to it here, and we are also selecting our input submit button, which is this button here, and applying hover color to this. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and resize this editor to this point and scroll down a little bit. Now it's turn to style these two buttons. Okay, let me scroll up, and here you can see that we want to add spaces between this icon, these icons and their text. Okay, so before we do that, let's jump into our HTML file and create a separator or divider for both elements. So I'm gonna go to my index.html file, and here I'm gonna create a span element you can see that here I am inside my paragraph element, and direct before the I element I gonna create a span element. So I write span and apply it two classes. Basically we gonna apply two classes here, which are, first one is divider, and let's call the second class is divider fb. We wanna copy this element and paste inside our Google Plus button before the I element, and let's change it fb to Google or GP. Okay, so that we can, so now it's turned to style this separator or divider. So let's do that. Jump into a CSS file. Here I gonna write a selector called form, and inside this form we will look for p element and then set it position property to relative, and it is very important and necessary property. You don't forget to specify this in your CSS file. Okay, so this will set these buttons p element as a relative, so that we can position those separators spans as a absolute to these paragraphs. Okay, so let's select our social button icons, which are F for Facebook and G plus for Google. So we can select that by writing social and then hyphen btn space I. This will select this Facebook and Google Plus icons. Okay, let's apply some basic styles to them. First of all, I wanna display it as an inline block so that we can apply some width and padding to it. Okay, so let's apply it a width of 5rem. So I think it is good for now. Let's apply it a font size of 1.6rem to make these icons little larger. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and set its text align property to center, and we want these to be vertically middle. So I'll write vertical align middle. Since it is inline block element, it so that we can apply vertical align property to it. Okay, let's apply another property called padding right 1.5rem to make little bit room for our separator. Okay, so here the separator will be displayed here. Okay, so now next we're gonna create that separator. So let's target those span that we have created earlier. So we can select that by writing divider class and simply going to set some properties. We're gonna set content to empty and display it as a block. Okay, let's give it a height of 100%, and we're gonna also position it as absolute. Okay, so that you can see that in preview a blue lines appear here, and let's down and let's set its left value to 4.5rem. okay, so you can see the little separator here. Now we're gonna go ahead and apply some box shadow effect to each of these individual separators. So okay, to select fb separator we can write divider class hyphen fb, and we're gonna apply some box shadow to it. So I'll write box shadow. Okay, and let's apply let's apply 0.515m for horizontal offset dot divider FB, and we're gonna apply it a box shadow of box shadow. We're gonna apply it a box shadow, and we're gonna apply it a box shadow. So I'll write box shadow. Here I'm gonna write 0.15 RAM for x axis or x offset, 0 for y offset, 0 for spread, and 0 for blur, and 0.03 for spread. So I'm gonna write this, and let's apply it a color of 0.496BAE. Okay, this which is dark blue type. Okay, you can see that here. And now we're gonna apply another box shadow to it by separating by a comma. So I'll write 0.25 m. okay, this is also going to be in m's, and let's 0.25 m 0 0 and 0.03 m's. okay, so now you can see that separator, and give it a color of 0.2 f 529 b. okay, so now you can see that we have created our separator for our Facebook element and Facebook button. Now it's time to create one for our Google Plus. So I'm gonna copy this and just going to change this from FB to GP. This will apply our styles to this Google Plus. Now we just need to change this color here, found D36F62. okay, now it's time to change this color too. So let's do that. We want to write this color to C B321F. So you can see that we have created our both separators using pure CSS. okay, so let's go ahead and style these input elements, which are email and password, and also our button element. Okay, so we are pretty close to what we are going to create. So quickly I'm gonna go ahead and apply some styles to these email and password inputs. So I'm gonna paste some code here. So we have selected those fields here, you can see that. Now I have applied some basic style to them. One pixel of solid border, which is of this color, and also text indent of 1 rem, which shift our text or placeholder text to left of 1 rem. And we have applied this color here, and you can also see that I have applied transition of 0.1 second for our font. I gonna show you quickly how why I applied this transition, because I want to transition the font size quickly when a person focus to this input field. So let me paste some code here to quickly show you. So here you go, you can see that I have selected the focus state of this password and input and email fields. Okay, and I am also selecting their active states by using this pseudo classes. Okay, so whenever I hover, whenever I focus on these elements, you can see that the font size of it will be increased, and border will be changed, and also color of this placeholder text will be changed. So let me show you guys. Now you can see that the password field font size is increasing, and also the border color is changing here. Okay, Now I also want to change the border color of these input fields when I hover over them. So to do that, I gonna paste some code here again, and this time we are targeting hover state, okay, by using hover class, pseudo class, okay. So we are this time applying 1 pixel of solid dark orange color, okay. So when you hover over, this will create a problem. So when you hover over and go to state, focus state, you will see this, it's behaving weird. But that's because we need to paste this hover state before this focus and active state. So remember this, we need these input hover, focus and active states in order, okay. So now we're gonna style our button, which is sign in button, okay. To target that, we wanna write input type button submit, and let's apply it a border of none, okay. Give it a background color of this, and let's set it font size to 1.2 rem, okay. And we also want to change the cursor when we hover over this button, so we'll write cursor pointer, okay. So let's, you can see that a hand cursor is displayed, pointer is displayed, okay. Now we have to style one more thing, which is this forget password and create an account. So we are going to quickly style this element, and so I'm gonna write here, if you remember what ID we have applied to this, to its parent element. So I think that was pound recover new account, and yes, this ID was applied to its parent, to their parent elements. So I gonna go ahead and display as a flex, okay, and set it justify content property to space around, so this will automatically distribute all three text elements here, which are forget password, this separator and this create account, okay. Now I'm gonna go ahead and apply some hover effect and colors quickly to this text forget password and create account. So I'm gonna go ahead and paste some code here, so you can see that we have applied a color of this and text line center. Similarly on hover effect, we are changing its color to little lighter, and we are applying a color of light red to our separator, okay. And now we have finished styling our form here, okay. So you can see that we have applied CSS style to our form, and it's looking awesome, okay. So well done, you did it. Now we're gonna apply some media queries to make it more responsive. So let's go ahead and at the end and write some media queries. So basically what we were going to write inside our media query, okay. So simply we want to change the root or base font size of our page, okay, at certain breakpoint. So I'll target that media query. I'll write at media, okay, and then I'll write only screen and max width of (768 pixels). Okay, and inside its curly braces we're gonna target our HTML element, which is the root element, and we'll change its base font size, which is earlier 15 pixels. We're gonna write here font size of 13 pixels. Okay, so you can see that in preview the changes that occurs. Okay, apply a width to our main element. So we can do that by simply writing main and apply it a width of about 70%. Okay, and let's apply a main width of 300 pixels. Okay, now you can go ahead and resize your browser size windows to any size you want, and this form will be automatically adjusted to its viewport size. So you see that. Okay, so guys, we have successfully built our login form with social media buttons. Okay, so I wanna say you thank you for watching this tutorial, and please hit like this video if you really like it, and subscribe to my channel to stay updated and get lots of videos related to web design and development. And I'll also share you some tips and tricks related to CSS, HTML, JavaScript, PHP, Node.js, Angular, and lot more. So subscribe to my channel and share with your friends. Once again, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye bye.